Have you ever been lost in the trends of an industry or topic you're used to? Let's say studies or new trends in a programming language. Tech companies have seen the incessant need for more powerful and sophisticated devices in our everyday lives, from school to health, BART, and the barest minimum of things you could think about. The daily development births a high drive demand for microchips. In such an industry, how do you fight to stay at the top of the game? Stay with us to find out how ASML has managed to stay in the game for so long. We would be looking at everything from its previous history to its innovation principles. Let's get started. The semiconductor industry is one of the most volatile industries in the world. From the continuous ups and downs in its stock to the constant advancement of its tech equipment, machines, and products. Not only does John Cena have unrivaled finishing ability, but the Dutch company has also demonstrated to be at the top of its game by advancing the Can You See Me strategy. Founded in 1984 in the Netherlands, the Dutch company did the Can You See Me smackdown, a considerable risk, by taking on uncharted territories in the research and development of EUVs. We mean, no one ever saw it coming. An expedition that their competitors thought of as being futile. It took the company over 15 years to glimpse the light at the end of the tunnel, delivering its first major products in 2022 with a market valuation of almost $200 billion. And a monopoly to maintain, since no other company comes close to the leading edge of its EUV lithography machines. You would also understand what it is like to be at the top, constantly being watched by your peers for a tiny lapse to exploit. This situation will literally make you staggered while performing your hit song at the O2, and this is no different for the world's largest provider of EUVs. Maintaining a large monopoly on EUVs sees a host of competitors from the likes of Ultratech, Canon, and Nikon, as well as Cadence Design Systems. You literally need to constantly renovate to stay relevant in this industry. ASML's success in recent years has made it more valuable than most companies in the semiconductor industry and the world today, including Intel, selling 125 EUV machines in September 2021 may not sound like much, but it would when you learn that ASML sells them for more than $100 million each and has a large number of demands from companies around the globe. What type of EUV do you own? Let us know in the comments section. How about opening your doors to your friends and partners to share and develop ideas on projects and works? Well, in 2012, ASML offered a quarter of its shares to its biggest customers, Intel, Samsung, and TSMC, to raise money, which it really needed to hasten its research and developments. This leads us to the strong innovation principles and methodology it uses as the tollgate of the digital highway. As individuals, we have different ways to achieve success. What are your principles for success and constant results? For ASML, a solid, innovative ecosystem has always meant a lot in driving the fast-paced technological chain in its core value system. Its technology was created in collaboration with its key partners through a knowledge network. As you probably know, there are other investment methods than simply throwing money at problems. Seeing this as a reinforcement of its innovation footprint for future generations to come, research and development. Aside from a large amount of money they pump into its research and development, ASML is not just constantly leaning on the future, but also on future generations of innovators. ASML today has more than 10,000 of its brightest minds in hardware and software come together to challenge each other to learn, grow, and take on the exciting task of innovating the most advanced lithography systems in the world. while still co-developing expertise within a broad network of technological partners, such as universities and research institutions, at the heart of its innovation. This approach allows it to hasten its innovation, adequately positioning the company at the disposal of youthful talent and ideas with a sizable leading-edge knowledge base across a wide range of technologies. Did you know that ASML's technology development and engineering departments are guided by the research department? Yeah! With over 11,000 employees, the development and engineering department D&E is tasked with carrying out the development and testing process. Interestingly, and not surprisingly, most ASML researchers are PhD holders in one of the many sciences or mathematics. ASML scouts and accepts applications from exceptional individuals once they complete their university studies, bringing them directly from their institutions into the company. Direct employment, you say? Everyone loves to have that. Human capital development is one of the most significant and reliable ways to get things done in a company or organization. So it is no wonder that ASML has pursued it. And it should be no surprise when we see the benefits it will undoubtedly bring in the coming years. Remember how, while you're working on a job or a school project, you thought to yourself, you know, this would have been a lot simpler if I had someone else working alongside me? Yes, that's correct. You can achieve a lot or a fair amount alone, but there is always a lot that can be accomplished by working together. And, like most companies in the semiconductor sector, ASML understands this, which is why collaboration has been a crucial aspect of its success. Developing its new technology in close collaboration with partners and even competitors within and outside the confines of the company in hopes of building an innovative ecosystem based on trust. ASML shares its risks and rewards while working hard to develop long-lasting relationships with its associates. And that's a brilliant idea for a leading company, don't you think? Take, for example, its long-lasting relationship and collaboration with the German manufacturer of optical systems and optoelectronics, Carl Zeiss AG, which has spanned well over three decades. An alliance aimed at driving operational excellence in order to expedite innovation in high-end A technology. There are also research collaborations with a number of European corporations and research institutes that are pursuing subsidized programs to advance integrated circuit technology for the next node. Currently spearheading a three-year PIN3S research project into 3-nanometer semiconductor technology, the EU will invest up to $31 million of the total $148 million in this initiative as part of its goal to enhance Europe's high-tech economy, while collaborating with universities and research institutes in Belgium, Twente, Delft, and Eindhoven. Not to forget the Advanced Research Center for Nanolithography in the Netherlands. By the end of 2021, ASML had 121 research and development partner agencies through the Eindhoven Startup Alliance, 1.0 million new rows invested in high-tech startups and scale-ups. Working with each other may have its downsides regarding safeguarding ideas and intellectual properties. But its positives are worth taking as it allows the semiconductor industry to accelerate innovation and create access to a base of shared knowledge across a wide range of technologies, similar to the risk ASML made in the 1990s to pursue the development of EUV technology when numerous firms elected not to take the risk, perceiving it as challenging and a money pit that would never succeed. ASML isn't backing down because it believes in that philosophy. Leaning toward the future, relying on new talent and the education system for appropriate ideas, while developing relevant and collaborative connections with its partners. However, ASML is one of many conducting research and developments within the industry now, but its close associates also. While the company looks at unveiling new products and outlets in 2024 and 2025, TSMC looks to be on the edge as it develops chips using 3 and 5 nanometer tech, making it the go-to producer for advanced semiconductors, which would definitely cause a real worry and stir to ASML. But TSMC isn't the only headache. Samsung also joins the race to develop the world's first 3 nanometer chip, and we definitely can't truly rule out. They have their eyes set on getting there by 2025. ASML may probably not be flinched by the barks of its competitors on what the future holds for them. The scenario might be different from what it was in the 1990s when ASML went on a soul journey in search of answers for the EUV, but it definitely wants a bite from whatever market may exist in future, not just a bark. We're sure you enjoyed this video, so make sure you like and comment under this video. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel and turn on notifications so you don't miss out on our other videos.